Now this argument over tattoo that ended in murder.
I just did it to shut her up. She was going to try to make my life a living hell. I told her, I'll kill you. You keep bothering me, I'll kill you.
John McQueen is a cold-blooded killer.
She tried to scream when I first put my hands around her neck, which made me squeeze tighter.
The two were arguing about a tattoo McQueen has of his wife's name. Atkins wanted it gone.
That she tried to come at him with a knife because she was going to carve my name out of his arm. He said that he finally snapped.
He had no regrets.
I knew she was going to keep f***ing with me.
Investigators say the man and woman got into some sort of altercation leading to that shooting. HPD Sergeant Arrington says a man in his late 20s shot and killed a 25-year-old woman, then himself. The sergeant adds officers have previously responded to this home in the past for a number of family violence calls. Now, investigators believe the two were in a long relationship. Part of the investigation, trying to see if any of the neighbors here may have heard anything or have any surveillance video.
News of a murder-suicide is rocking the neighborhood around Rain Willow Court in Southwest Harris County. 22-year-old ex-boyfriend showed up at the home of who relatives have identified as 23-year-old Tamara Sawyer and killed her, then himself around 3 p.m.
Mark Caribe Luis Madrigal is now being charged with second-degree murder, but his ex's close friends believe the county attorney should up that to a first-degree murder charge because they believe Madrigal planned out his attack. Her friends say Monique had been dating Luis Madrigal for 13 years, but had recently broken up. They claim he showed up to the store Saturday morning asking to get some things out of her car. Police say the 27-year-old snapped, beating Monique to death with a tire iron and carved the word cheater into her car. Then, while standing over her body, told a witness to call police.
Stephanie Saldana was just 26 years old. Her brother and sister say she was finally starting to get her life together, looking to move into a home with her two children. But an argument with her boyfriend changed everything.
Jonathan Esparza is still trying to understand why his sister, Stephanie Saldana, is gone.
Because that she didn't want to unlock her phone, some type of jealous rage came over him.
Stephanie's older sister, Denise, says Stephanie and her boyfriend, Christian, had relationship issues, but that she kept a lot of those issues to herself. Stephanie and her boyfriend, Christian, got into an argument. Detectives learned from witnesses that the two were arguing when Christian shot Stephanie. Police say he then turned the gun on himself. He died on scene. Stephanie later died at the hospital.
Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, and today we're gonna be talking about lick back culture. So welcome to the real talk. I know every single day we scrolling on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, MySpace, Backpage, let me stop, and we seeing somebody getting shot, killed, stabbed, kidnapped, anything, because anything is possible these days. And it's all because someone done cheated, somebody took somebody, somebody did something they wasn't supposed to do, and somebody wanted they lick back. Okay, now if you guys are not aware of what lick back means, lick back essentially means getting your vengeance back in the worst way possible, taking karma into your own hands. Okay, and lately I think we could all agree that lick back culture has gotten completely out of hand. Like, these people are low-key crazy. You guys are cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Like, yo, low-key I'll be thinking like, yo, if me and my man were to ever break up, which Jesus Christ, I really hope it never happens, I would be terrified to ever date again, because some of y'all are really off y'all rockers. Like, do you guys not have plans? Do you guys not have a god? Do you, like, some of y'all are nuts. Like, as you guys saw from the intro clip, it doesn't make any sense how some people get so enraged to the point where they really think that they are the higher authority, that they can just take somebody's life. That's one thing to be figuratively sitting there like, oh, I'ma beat your ass, you know, I'ma take your life, I'ma get somebody to beat you up. But like, some of y'all be dead ass, like, I'ma take your life, like y'all is crazy. Like, y'all is real crazy. Now listen, you know I'm Haitian, right? You know, a lot of us, we be saying shit like, you know, I'ma do some voodoo on you, I'ma turn you into a goat or whatever. I've said that a couple times to a couple people. And listen, my ancestors don't like that shit, in terms of, yeah, if you do some shit to me, my ancestors might do something to you. But like, damn, I don't be serious. And none of my exes or anything have ever turned into a goat. But like, you guys are nuts out there. Like, it's very, very crazy. And I think it's something that needs to be talked about. Like, I don't understand how so many people are that emotionally imbalanced that they think that they have the right to literally take someone's life or literally maim them to the point of no repair just because they cheated on them or just because they literally hurt them so badly. Like, is it really that fucking serious? Like, seriously, like, is it ever that serious? Of course, we all know a couple infamous stories, okay? From catcalling stories to, of course, some of the latest stories, like the one of the nurse that was literally driving 90 miles per hour in California that hit all of those cars that literally took 6 lives. Allegedly. Now, I'm saying allegedly because it was never confirmed in stories, but literally, you know, on Instagram and stuff, they said that she had got a text message from her boyfriend and had found out that, like, he was cheating on her, whatever the case may be, and she literally just plowed into traffic and she had some mental issues. And of course, there's that one story that you guys did just see in the beginning of that one woman that literally was at Kroger's with her boyfriend and saw that he was cheating on her with her sister and literally plowed into him while he was in the parking lot and then killed another man in the process of doing that. Do you guys not understand that sometimes there's gonna be other casualties to y'all madness? Like, I don't understand. And of course, there's consistently lots of men out there that just do not like not having power over their girlfriends, okay? Their girlfriends will leave them. Their girlfriends will probably contest the fact that they're abusing them, whatever case may be. And they will take their lives and sometimes their own. Or they will just take their lives and take the lives of their children, or whatever the case may be. And these stories are so repetitive and it's insane because sometimes they literally mirror each other. How in the world is it that these stories just keep happening over and over and over again? What causes these people to do this? And most importantly, what causes people to think that this is okay? I gathered a couple things, and of course, feel free to comment down below. One, have you ever went through someone actually trying to, like, really physically harm you because of something that happened in a relationship? And why do you think that people do things like this? Because I could never wrap my head around it. Like, I've had some men do some real shicey things to me. I've had some girls do some shicey things to me because of men. But, like, I don't think it can ever get to this. Nobody is that important to risk your life or your freedom to literally, like, risk putting yourself behind bar. Like, it's just, it's scary. You know, it truly is. So, one thing I will say, love is hard. It really is. And especially for people that fall hard and people who literally have nobody else and that person that they're in a relationship with is the only person that they have. I will say that it makes genuine sense how those types of people would fall ridiculously hard for their significant other. Because when you really think about it, when you have someone that you love, when you have someone and you look at that someone as literally your only family and your lover, and then they betray the hell out of you, I can guess that that would literally send you into a spiral. Not trying to justify them murdering people and maiming people and all that, but I'm saying I can understand to an extent, like, why someone would literally go off their rocker if someone was to betray them to that type of extent. Because it's like, damn, like, how could you do that to me? Like, how can you cheat on me? How can you betray me? How could you hit me? How could you whatever? Because it's like, you're my only family. You're the only thing I got, you know? So that makes perfect sense. Betrayal hurts like hell. I mean, it really does. I've been betrayed a couple times, but I can say when I was actually, like, loving the person or was in love with the person to an extent where I guess felt like I was, because there's times I thought I was in love, but I clearly wasn't. I felt like hell. Oh my God, I couldn't do nothing. I couldn't eat. I couldn't sleep. I couldn't, oh Lord. So being betrayed by those people, yeah, you know, it hurts your pride. It hurts your ego. It hurts your heart. You know, you ever heard of dying from a broken heart? That's a real thing. There's a real name for it, but they call it dying of a broken heart. That's a real thing, you know, and you won't probably love the same again. And some people, they remedy that by, you know, resorting to violence. Shoo, I ain't gonna lie. Like, I've been cheated on numerous times, but I think we need to all admit that I don't think most of us would resort to murder. Or hitting somebody with a car or shooting the person. Like, it's just that, I don't know. Like, I get the hurt though, but it's just like, what drives someone to that? So when I was looking into it, there were certain articles that said that some people have a predisposition to resorting to violence, either due to childhood trauma or just genetically. Now, I know many of you have probably heard of the serial killer gene. Y'all, apparently it's a thing, but ethically, you really shouldn't call it the serial killer gene. But it's basically a gene that makes you more prone to using violence. That's the best way to explain it. It's called the MHOA, something like that. I'll put it on the screen. But essentially, there's some people that are just born with that gene. It doesn't mean you're gonna like grow up to kill people, essentially. But it's something that you should look out for. Not everybody knows that they have it. You have to like literally go through testing to find out if you have it. But of course, there's other genes to look out for too that certain people have that may make them, you know, more prone to physical violence or whatever the case may be. It's very scary because when you think about it, it's like, damn, there's people walking around out there that just have a predisposition for violence. And that's wicked. But of course, okay, especially for those of you guys that's in high school, college, understand, number one, it's never ever that serious to be out here taking somebody's life just because they cheated on you, just because they betrayed you, just because they looked at you a certain way, just because they put their hands on you, which, let me just clarify, self-defense, I don't give a fuck, you do what you gotta do. But understand that a lot of states don't have a self-defense law, and both of y'all gonna be in jail. So you have to understand, you have to take the proper protocol and understand the laws in your state before you go around doing goofy shit. Because sometimes he may have hit you first, she may have hit you first, but then you fuck around, you hit them back, and now y'all both in jail. Now y'all kid don't got a parent, kids in the system, da 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 da. Not saying let the person kill you, but if it's not life and death, be very, very careful what you do, because not everybody or not every state is gonna take that self-defense shit. And plus, you have to have like proof. You gotta do something. Like, make sure you could have a camera or something recording, because a lot of states don't give a fuck. Like, they really don't. Self-defense is not always a defense, which sucks. Like, I just found that out. I'm like, oh, that's ridiculous. So also take that into account when it comes to weapons too. Just because you got a weapon and you defending yourself don't mean that's always a legal weapon, okay? Sometimes you can have a legal gun, but that don't mean you can walk around with that legal gun, okay? So be very, very careful. There's more life outside of this relationship. There's too many of y'all that be out here, oh, I love my boyfriend, I love my girlfriend. Okay, what about your friends? What about your family? What about your job? What about your hobbies? What about your business? What about everything else that you enjoy in life? You can't just be wrapped up in your relationship so much to the point where if they do hurt you, you ain't got shit else. See, that's the problem with a lot of y'all. I told my cousin, I'm gonna make a song called Don't Call Me When Y'all Break Up, because me and her was talking about how we got friends that literally they be so wrapped up in their fucking relationships that they don't fucking call nobody. I love my nigga to death, but my man is not my fucking purse. I don't bring my man everywhere I go. I literally am still able to maintain all of my friendships and relationships outside of my relationship. Why can't other people do that shit? It don't make sense. If you're literally in a relationship where like literally that person's so insecure that they can't let you go out and you can't have other friends, you shouldn't be in that relationship. That's a very, very big ass red flag. Like, and I'm not talking about no goddamn kind of ass. Like, that's a problem. Like, that's really a problem. Like, I kid you not, it gets me so mad when like I have a friend that I literally am so close to, and as soon as they get a boyfriend or a girlfriend, never see them ever again. They never call me. But as soon as they break up, oh, you father, oh, she broke up with me. Oh, he broke up with me. Don't call me when you break up. 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 I'm dead ass gonna make that a song. Like, I'm gonna be a rapper, y'all. Who's gonna support my rap career? Send me a Cash App. Same as my handle, D-Mel. T-H-E-E-M-L-L-E. Send me a Cash App. Support my studio time. I'm gonna make a song called Don't Call Me When You Break Up. I'm dead, cause like, are y'all dead? Ass. Like, and the thing is, you're part one. Like, they have no shame. As soon as they break up, oh, you thought it was good, you wanna chill, yo, me and da-da-da broke up. Fuck you! No, I don't, actually. Who are you? I have no idea who you are. I don't, actually. Like, be wary of people like that. Be wary of being in relationships with people that get mad when you have other friends, because that is unfucking healthy. You have to have other relationships outside of your relationship. You have to. No one deserves to be maimed or killed because of your rage. Get anger management. I don't know why people don't get anger management anymore. I don't know what's going on, but go and get anger management, okay? Like, if you need it, go and get it, okay? If you have insurance, go and get it. If you don't have insurance, go and barter, okay? You can barter. Therapists and other types of mental health professionals will barter their prices. If you don't have the money, trust me. If you know you have anger issues, if you know you literally go 0 to 1,000 real quick, you might need some anger management and it might really benefit you, especially if you know you go 0 to 100 at a job. You know you go 0 to 100 with your friends. You know you go 0 to 100 in your relationships. That's something that needs to be rectified. That's something that needs to be explored. Why do you go to 0 to 100? Is it something from your childhood trauma? Is it something that happened in your adulthood? Is it something that, is it just that person? Maybe you need to leave. Better yet, maybe you need relationship counseling. Now, this is something that my therapist just told me recently. Apparently, people should go to relationship counseling before they have problems. What do you know? If you need it, go and get it, okay? Because before it gets worse and before you want to strangle the person in your sleep, you might as well go get it now. Karma is a bitch. Before you go and get your lick back, understand karma's gonna come right back around to you. You just gonna be going tit for tat with karma. You gonna sit there, you gonna get your lick back, you gonna be sitting in jail, okay? And then karma gonna get you in there. Okay, you cannot be sitting there taking revenge into your own hands. When I'm telling you, when my ex has sat there and left me for his best friend's bitch, you didn't see that? You need to go see that. It's on my third channel. Thought of every which way to go get that nigga as the Capricorn that I am, because we love vengeance. I've got my lick back so many times on so many people, but there's a lot of people that I didn't get my lick back on because I realized that they were just such shitty people that I didn't have to. And that's something that a lot of you guys have to realize. There's some people that are just bad people. Like, some people are just shitty people that, like, you don't have to do anything. Why was it feeling like it? Like, there's nothing you have to do because karma, bro. Karma already is like at their door, just looking for a way, just planning the best revenge, okay? You need to understand, some things is not your job. You know how, like, some people, they only get paid minimum wage, so it's like, why would I do somebody else's job? Do what you paid to do. Why are you taking extra shifts if you only getting paid to do your shift? Do not work extra hours. Let karma do its job. And karma did serve me well, so karma will do its job when it's time. And to be honest, it may not be today, it may not be tomorrow, it may not be the next day, but it's gonna come. Just wait. And like I said, go to therapy. Sometimes you might have to go to therapy for yourself. Even if you don't want to go to therapy with your significant other, go to therapy for yourself. See what's going on with you. See what's going on with anything that you may have to address in your past, because sometimes there's things that you may have forgot, things that may have been suppressed, and then they come to the surface and you realize, damn, I'm an angry ass bitch. That's probably why I'm always latching out on motherfuckers. So it's like, there's a lot of things that kind of boil to the surface as to why people just be lashing out like that. And you know what's really interesting to me with these types of cases and people that just be like lashing out on their boyfriends and girlfriends when they find out that they betrayed them? It's the ones that be bragging. It's the ones that be sitting there like, yeah, I did it, and yeah, I did it to shut her up, and da-da-da-da. It's like, no, like, you're really a psychopath. Like, there's something wrong with you. Like, how, Sway? Like, you could at least act like you're sorry. You can at least act like you give a fuck. Like, y'all don't even be caring. Like, y'all just be like, yeah, I don't give a fuck, and fuck that bitch, and like, y'all don't even care. Like, you don't even give a damn. You don't even give a damn. So what type of people should you avoid to avoid getting licked back? You know what I mean, to basically avoid someone seeking revenge on you. First of all, seek and give closure always. This is something that I always see being an issue when it comes to like people getting attacked after a breakup. It's always lack of closure. They don't know where they stand. They think that they together when they not. They sitting there like on the balance, like, oh, I don't know if she wants me, I don't know if he wants me, da 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 da. Next thing you know, they with a new girl, and then they get mad, they break into the house, they slash and tire. Give closure. And I know this is always something that people get so riled up with every single time I say it on this channel and my third channel, because I give a lot of advice videos, and giving closure is always something I always preach about. And what y'all need to understand is you need to grow the fuck up. If you can't give closure to the people that you once loved, then you really probably don't know how to fucking communicate, and you should not be in any relationship. And I know a lot of people are gonna be like, oh, well, that person hurt me, they did this, they did that. Okay, well, I'm very sure you weren't a saint either, bitch, because I know I'm not a saint in every single situation. But at the end of the day, you need to learn how to grow the fuck up and give closure to people, just like they need to give closure to you. And at the end of the day, I'm very sure, just like they're gonna run their mouth about you, you're gonna run their mouth about them. I'm very sure both of you would love to know what the fuck you're running your mouths about. So give the fucking closure. It's not that damn hard. Like, dang it, just go, say your piece, let them say their piece, and that's it. Okay, as long as the person ain't beat the shit out of you, okay? And yeah, if you want to give closure and whatever, receive closure on that end, I suggest having a mediator, like an officer there. But like, ended on terms that, like, you know, there wasn't any violence that ensued. I think it shouldn't be that big of a deal to be like, yo, this is what happened, this is what happened, this is what happened, I don't want to be with you anymore, whatever. Like, but like, ending on really big, negative, violent blowouts and then just separating almost always ends in a whole bunch of lick back tit for tat. I can't even tell you how many times I went on missions with my friends to do this, that, and the third. I ain't proud of myself, but that's all I'm gonna say. I ain't gonna incriminate myself. But it's just like, oh my God, can't we just talk to him? Can't we just talk to her? Can't we, I have to go? And it's like, bro. And then years later, they done talked. It's like, oh damn, that's how you felt? Damn, I didn't know that. Damn, I'm sorry I slashed the tires off your car. And it's like, simple conversation, people. It's not that difficult. See if there's a cognitive issue at play. Understand that sometimes when you're dealing with people, you're dating people, they're not always gonna be comfortable telling you that they have a mental illness. So if they are mentally ill, they're probably gonna tell their, you know, brother, sister, mother, father, find out. And if they don't know, their family probably knows that there's a history of it in their family. So find that out before you go talking shit and da da da, find out. Because I found out that there was a dude that I used to like a lot in high school. I found out that he was bipolar, and I'm also bipolar, but he's like rapid cycling in a psych ward type bipolar. And I'm telling you, it was crazy because I went back into our old Facebook messages one day and he was cursing me the fuck out, calling me a bitch and a hoe and all types of shit. And I was like, yeah, I don't remember all fucking like your bitch ass. And I was really about to get his ass beat. See, I was bad back in the day. And I'm like, yo, like, it's crazy because I didn't know. I didn't know until his sister was posting on Facebook, like, yeah, my brother's in a psych ward, he's bipolar, da da da. And I was like, see, now I would have got his ass beat because he was out here calling me out my name or whatever. See, misunderstanding. And back in the day, I had a really big ego issue. You're not about to call me a bitch and a hoe and all of that, especially when I don't even know you like that, for you to be calling me a hoe. You never seen my coot coot. But so, you know, like, I was young, y'all. I was like 19. You never know what people are going through, so you should always find that out. People who are codependent. I don't want to say avoid people who are codependent, but avoid people who are codependent. People who cannot stand on one leg. People who ain't got no goddamn family. This sounds so fucking bad. But like, a lot of those people, they be the ones. Damn. Those people that are really, really codependent, those people that ain't got no family, those people that ain't got shit for real, like, and they just relying on you for everything, they're gonna be the ones to lash out when something happens. They're gonna be the ones to leave you in the dirt when something happens. They're gonna be the ones that really cannot control their emotion. Watch out for that shit. People who never, ever let you speak for yourself. If you are with somebody and they're constantly over-speaking you, they never let you speak up for yourself, they never let you have an opinion every single time that you speak to them, they make you feel bad or they guilt trip you, be very, very careful. Because first of all, that may lead to an abusive situation, and second of all, why would you want to be with somebody where you can't even speak up for yourself? Physically and mentally abusive. I think that's a dead giveaway. And of course, people who talk poorly about you. Understand, if you're with somebody and they talking poorly about you, I don't know why you even want to be with them. But like, if they're talking poorly about you, that means they're already building a character assassination about you so they can assassinate you. You ever realize that a lot of times in like murder cases and shit, when the families be talking about people, like, it'd be mad drastically different. Oh yeah, she was a really amazing person. And then with him, it's just like, yeah, he was bad. But then the family of the guy, it'll be completely opposite. No, she was the bad person. That's what he told us. Da, 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 da. And it's like, how could the family, well, families of two married people be saying something completely different about two married people? Did y'all not have gatherings? Did y'all not come together? How could you talk about the wife this way? Yeah, be very, very careful. Show up at all them fucking gatherings. Make sure they ain't saying shit about you. That's what I always say. If the family don't like you, don't even do it. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Comment down below. What do you guys think about lick back culture? Make sure you guys subscribe to my other two channels. Chronicles of the Zoe is my Haitian channel where I talk about Haitian politics, voodoo, and folklore from a Haitian American perspective. And VE More is my vlog channel where I do personal content, vlogs, story times, and shit like that. Everything you need is linked down below. Get your merchandise, do all of that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!